Garrison.
Yes?
Glad you came. Sorry about the precautions.
Well, I just hope it was worth my while, Mr.
I could give you a false name, but I won't. Just call me X.
I've already been warned by the agency, Mr. Whoever, so this is another type of threat.
Not with the agency, Mr. Garrison. And I assume if you've come this far, what I have to say interests you. But I'm not going to name names or tell you who or what I represent, except to say you're close. You're closer than you think. Okay? Everything I'm going to tell you is classified top secret. I was a soldier, Mr. Garrison. Two wars. I was one of those secret guys in the Pentagon that supplies the military hardware, the planes, bullets, rifles, for what we call black operations. Black ops. Assassinations, coup d'etat, rigging elections, propaganda, psych warfare, and so forth. World War II, I was in Romania, Greece, Yugoslavia. I helped evacuate part of the Nazi intelligence apparatus just before the end of the war. And we used those guys in the fight against the communists. In Italy, 48, we stole the elections. France, 49, broke the strikes. Overthrew Carino in the Philippines, Arbenz in Guatemala, Mozadeg in Iran. We were in Vietnam in 54, Indonesia 58, Tibet 59. Got the Dalai Lama out. We were good. Very good. Then we get into the Cuban thing. Not so good. Set up all the bases for the invasion. Supposed to take place in October 62. Mm-hmm. Khrushchev sent the missiles to resist the invasion. Kennedy didn't invade. And we were standing out there with our dicks in the wind. A lot of pissed off people, Mr. Garrison. Understand? I'll come to that later. So, 1963. I spent much of September 63 working on the Kennedy plan for getting all U.S. personnel out of Vietnam by the end of 1965. This plan was one of the strongest, most important papers issued from the Kennedy White House.
His National Security Action Memo 263 ordered home the first 1,000 troops for Christmas. But then in November, 1 week after the murder of Vietnamese President Dien in Saigon and 2 weeks before the assassination of our president, a strange thing happened to me. The Panama...
T-47. Sarah, dead in there? The point is, the weapons need to be where the troops are. That's...
Colonel? I got a note saying you want to see me, General.
I do indeed. You are going to the South Pole.
I am?
You are. Dr. Mooney's got all the details. I want you to check with him. Have yourself a nice vacation.
I was sent by my superior officer, we'll call him Y. I was sent by General Y to the South Pole as the military escort for a group of international VIPs. I was on my way back in New Zealand when the president was killed. Now, Oswald was charged at 7 p.m. Dallas time with Tippett's murder. That's 2 o'clock in the afternoon of the next day, New Zealand time. But already, their papers had the entire history of this unknown 24-year-old man, Oswald. Studio picture, detailed biographical data, Russian information, and were pretty sure of the fact that he killed the president alone, although it took them 4 more hours before they even charged him with that crime in Dallas. It felt to me as if, well, that cover story was being put out, like we would in a black op. Anyway, after I came back, I asked myself, why was I, the chief of special ops, selected to travel to the South Pole at that time to do a job that any number of others could have done? And I wondered if it could have been because one of my routine duties, if I had been in Washington, would have been to arrange for additional security in Texas. So I decided to check it out.